All right, it's October. We're gonna chase some crappies, man. Perfect weather, you know? Little bit of wind, but it's early. It's supposed to calm right down this afternoon. And in Northern Ontario, the black crappie opportunities are limitless. You just gotta find different lakes, different areas that have crappie, and just go there. Figure it out, man. Go to a nice lodge, stay someplace, go with your buddies, your best friends. Hey, take your wife, your girlfriend, and just enjoy the fantastic autumn weather. But we want to catch some fish. So the crappies this afternoon, I'm going to fish the good old way that, you know, everybody loves to fish crappies. And how's that? With a slip float, little bobber, something signaling a bite. But I got it on that 6-pound test, okay? And I got it where I'm going to set about 4 feet, and I put it up to a bobber stop. At the money end, I have the little slab magnet right there, 1/8 ounce, little jig head. And I got it in that white with chartreuse. Very, very sharp hooks. And I'm gonna throw it on the B&M Sam Super Sensitive and Crappie Wizard. I have multiple rods rigged up, so I'm rigged and ready. All of a sudden it just goes down. Or it lays sideways. And crappies bite. They eat like this, and the float sitting like this, and the float goes on its side. You know he's come up and he's holding it. He's not swimming, he's not going anywhere. The float goes. Set hook, man. There's nothing else can do that. But a crappie bite. Working that little weed edge. Casting, 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 waiting, thinking, come on, man, come on. I've been fishing all afternoon, getting a few bluegills and stuff, some smaller crappie. Go, and I decide just to stick with the slab magnet. Just stick with it. The bright white with the chartreuse. What happens? My beautiful slip float is sitting like this. I'm twitching it. All of a sudden, it just goes bloop, sideways. Sideways, what happens? Big, beautiful, fat slab to start my evening.
It is too. See it? Big one. Big crappie. Lay down the float, dude.
Look at that.
Do you want to eat that bait? Lay that float down hard, dude. Lay that float down hard. That's not a bad start, eh? Look at the size of him. Big crappie. Let's put him in there. Okay?
When I'm out there fishing on those weed lines, edges and things like that, I wanna have a few rods and different poles ready. I'm gonna rig up with the crappie magnet, the slab magnet, but we're looking for some bigger crappies. So that bigger profile, the little kicking tail, big fat shad body, and they're super, super soft. I spray on a little bit of scent, you know, and that's all we're gonna do, and hopefully find some crappies on the deep weeds in October.
Hook's a little down. I need to take it up, open the gap like that. Open up the gap, get more fish in the boat. Open the gap, I'll be going a little bit more. I want to get that upper lip right there. Let's see.
But something about that evening frenzy.
There's a good one. Oh yeah, big crappie, dude. Big crappie. Big slab. Look at that. Look at that. How about that? It's like way down. Look at that. Way down, downtown. Right at the top lip. That's a good eater right there.
This is my crappie candy right here. This is what I love. All the colors and tastes and you name it, boy. Smorgasbord. But for this afternoon, I'm going to throw that little snow white with the chartreuse tail. It's a favorite. Another one looks like lemon meringue. It's got a lot of light lime, a little bit of milky white kind of stuff, okay? This is fantastic when you get an aggressive bite. The bright orange, the chartreuse tail. You see my common theme, right? Chartreuse, chartreuse, chartreuse. I want them to see it, because the crappies see it, I will get them to bite. Then maybe I'll have the good old therapist. Again, it's got purple, and it's got some chartreuse. Those right there are my choices right here.
Come on, big crappie, where are you? Crappie right there, dude. Yep, look at the size of him. Just finished saying, huh? Look at the size of him.
Big, beautiful slab crappie. Eating the slab magnet, dude.
October slabs, I'd say that's nice. Look at that beautiful fish.
I got that little Northland sliding slip float. And this one I got in a real like snow white. Snow white with a chartreuse little tail. And it's on the Crappie Wizard 7.6. This is a fantastic rod. I can make those long bomb casts because I'm gonna be looking for fish, looking for activity. Until they really go on a bite, you know, I need to find where they maybe are. Thicker clumps of weeds, 7 feet, 9 feet, 8 feet. Just moving around, using the sonars. Garmin shows me the side view, see where the weeds start and begin. But I want to find the thickest clumps, throw that little slab magnet, and just shake it. Once in a while, just shaking it, provoking a bite. It's so important, especially with crappie fishing, not to just sit and wait for a bite. You know, we're not using live minnows and stuff. We're using little plastics. So I want to utilize a little tail kicking just to provoke a strike. I'm in different weed from 7 feet, 8 feet, 9, 10, 11, 12, and the weed's all over the place, clumps and stuff like that. But I want to find the most aggressive fish, so I keep moving the trolling motor. As soon as I start getting bit, slow down, work that little area, and then maybe stay in the same depth and look for activity. Seeing bait fish, the loons and stuff, and start casting around the boat and see where those fish are, where the majority are, or where they're starting. So in the meantime, keep casting, working around, different depths. No rhyme or reason for a certain depth. I just keep fishing all the way around here. My third option on the SAM Super Sensitive again, sliding slip float, little B&M Pro 100 reel, 6 pound test still. And this thing around this one has a little bit smaller 1/16th ounce jig head with the Crappie magnet right there. Red with chartreuse, sharp hook, the little split tail. You shake that, bounce it back and forth. So I got two options, a smaller little profile and a slab magnet. One of these is going to catch crappie for me.
Just lay it down. There it goes. Look, oh, there's a crappie. See that? You see that? Hit my float, dude. Hit my float. Look, got him. Just a nice fish, man. Just a nice crappie. But he just finished hitting my float. Isn't that wild? Isn't that wild? We're gonna take some fish home, but he's a bit smaller than what we want right there. I'm gonna put those power poles down, dude. 7.5 feet of water. There's fish right in front of us here. We're gonna fish the spot right in front here. See if we can catch a few more crappies. When you hit your float, you know that they're getting ready to go nuts. Missing those. That was heavy too. Oh, they laid down. Sometimes, honest to God, man, it's incredible. You're watching that float, I'm twitching the rod, and all it does is just go slowly like this. You lean back and there's a fish on. It's incredible how soft they can bite. You need that little bait. Wow. That's why the sensitive rod, the B&M, man, big difference. It felt heavier. Oh yeah, another crappie, dude. Look. Smiling and catching. Smiling and catching. That's what we're doing, dudes. We're smiling and catching. I'm gonna say they're bluegills, or I'm gonna say they're small crappie. Big crappie do not miss. They just eat. And this one right there. So I keep popping it, driving nuts to see it. Come on, crappie. Good crappie right there, dude. This is a huge crappie, dude. Look at this. Look at that. Oh my goodness me. Hey. Am I smiling? I'm smiling. Poles down, I ain't moving. You dissect the spot. Worst thing you can do is just keep moving around and you actually find a little school of fish sitting in that weed.
Now we're getting it done. Isn't it incredible? You know, you're fishing on those areas and you're kind of second guessing yourself. Is there crappie here? But when they come out of those weeds, there's no second guessing. everywhere you look, they're pushing up bait. The seagulls are on a flurry in different areas of deep clumps. I'm fishing with 7, 8, 9 feet of water and just throwing around, twitch, twitch. But the key is those thicker clumps. As soon as I get close to those thicker clumps, I cast over it, bring the float closer to it, twitch, twitch, boom, down it goes.
Take it down, boy. Wow, I love it when they do that. You're sitting right inside that weed, eh? Whoa, dude. This is sick, dude. This is sick. Big gill. Look at the size of this gill. But after a crappie hit my float, look at the size of that bluegill. I know what you're saying. Why isn't he eating them? Is that a handful of gill? That's a handful plus right there. Wow. Let him go. Knocking the float. Where's the big crappie? Where? Come on. Come on. Come on. You tease. All of a sudden the float goes boom. You see them hit the float? See that? That's one right there. What do you think of that, huh? What do you think of that? Look at that. Look at that. What do you think of that, hey? Oh yeah, man. I think it's fun times in Wild Crappieville. Fun times in Wild Crappieville. Let's put them in the box. And we'll feed a crappie in fall. Fall, feed a crappie.
I can't tell you how much fun it is when you can tie on a little bait like the slab magnet and keep catching crappie. They're so durable and soft. When they inhale it, they inhale it. There's no second guessing, none around the little membrane on the lip and stuff like that. When they eat it, they mean it.
That might be crappie. It's big too. It is. It's just nice, look. Just nice. You think he's in the weed? Take a look at that. Look at his mouth. No salad. Not with these crappie. They just live in a salad. He's just a little guy. Ready? Go on. Let's put it right back out. Let's see if there's a big one with him. A little thick weed I'm in right there. Yeah. Look at the thick back on him. That's what you want right there. You find that thick weed, boy. You know what's in it? Those single pole fish that you catch right there. Well, I'm gonna look for some big ones. We got a few little eaters now. Come on. I just gotta stay on that weed, boy. Stay on that weed. I love when they hit the float. Look at that. That's a big one, dude. That's a big crappie. Look at this. I kid you not. Look at this. Wow. Think I can hide my excitement? Look inside his mouth. Look inside there. Think he wanted that? I'd say he wanted that, dudes. When you gotta get them pliers and you gotta find that hook bend and bend it back, turn it just like that, you know. You have found yourself one big floppy, sloppy, crappie. Right there, Ontario's finest, black and gold. So now I'm catching some decent fish. I'm getting some 10, 11, 12 inchers and stuff. And I'm seeing a lot of bait fish being pushed up in 12, 13 feet. So I move off that real thick weed line to the deeper weed in 12, 13 feet, make those casts, and now I'm catching those bigger fish that maybe are suspending, pushing up the bait off the weed lines closer to deep water main lake basin. I've moved around now and I'm still catching fish, but you gotta keep on it. Keep on the spot, almost like you gotta turn them off, like right there. That, if it's a crappie, it's big, dude. If it's a crappie, it's big, but I don't know if it is. It is.
Crazy, crazy crappie.
One of the most enjoyable fish to catch, eat, and enjoy with family and friends. there's one right there. I felt that. Is that a big crappie? Is it? Oh my goodness, look at these fish, dude. Look at this. Look at these fish. Seriously, look at that, man. He couldn't have got it any closer to the edge. Let's put him in a box. He's gonna make my family happy.
Okay, as for crappie magnets, here's my choices again. I like the red with chartreuse. I got some black with chartreuse right there. Obviously the snow white with chartreuse. Orange, same thing on the tail. That chartreuse will always be on one of my rods. The therapist, so I got some purple. You know, I just got some options. This is my candy case number two. Slab magnets are number one. Crappie magnets are number two. I'm looking for big black slabs. I got lots of colors, lots of options, lots of opportunity.
Come on, crappie. Just seen one take the float. Yeah, right there again, eh? Big crappie too, look at this. Oh boy. Sitting out here, huh? Oh my goodness, look at this. This is what I come for right here. More than a handful of slab. Look at that. Right at twilight. Right at twilight, we're almost done. I pulled off about 8.5 feet of water. The sun is behind the clouds. I'm hopefully gonna catch a couple more that are hitting my float and go in, enjoy my evening, and come back again tomorrow and catch some more.
Man, you talk about fun. An October evening, catching crappies with a little slip float, slab magnet. I didn't have to go to a jerk bait, didn't have to go to a little fin spin, you know, just stuck with the slab magnet. And man, oh man, it got me a feed of crappie. I think I kept 10 to take home just to enjoy with the family.
Underhand pitches around the boat where he just caught. I'll show you where they are. See, there's all weed out there too. You can see where the gulls are eating. Those are probably damaged bait fish hit by those crappies and floating up. Seagulls know. Go down to feed. Wow. There's a good one right there again. Is that crappie? Is it? Oh my goodness, look at this. Look at this, dude. Look at this. Oh my goodness me, huh? Look at that. Out here in the deep clumps, we is catching some big, beautiful Ontario big black crappie. Look where that slab magnet is. Yeah? Oh yeah. Them big ones sit out here. They're the ones that are pounding the bait out here that the gulls are knocking. I need to get the pliers. You know that's a good fish. You gotta get them pliers and you got it right in the meat. Take it, just turn it, put it down. Look at that, man. What's wrong with that? That is a fantastic, beautiful example of Ontario crappie. Put him in here with his friends. Carl's gonna have a meal. Gonna make everybody happy.
What are you, Carl?
Guess what? I was crappie fishing, boys. Did you catch any? And I'll hand him a little bag of fillets and say, enjoy yourself. In the meantime, watch this. Throw right back there. Same spot. Hopefully it goes down. I'm in 9 feet of water. The weed comes up about 6. So there's a 3 or 4 foot window. And that's where they're at, those big ones. Chasing bait, eating bait. I tell you, man, it is so, so much fun. Slip float, look at it. Got it about 4 feet. B&M, crappie wizard, and it is like a wizard, because now it's finding me some bigger fish at the edge of twilight, on the edge of the evening. Look how those seagulls, look at them, look at that. Dude, that is like you see shark frenzy. Look, it's because, oh my God, is that a crappie? It is too, dude, it's a crappie. Look, this is what we come for right here, out here in the deep weed. Look, hey, you just gotta move around, boys. Have some fun. Look at that. He ate that, didn't he? Oh my goodness me. Just gotta pop it back. That's a good one. He's going in the box, dudes. We only got time for maybe, I'd say 10 minutes. 10 minutes more, okay? Crappie? Yep, big one too. Oh boy. Look at this again. Oh no! Put it back in the same spot. Hey? He says he's crazy. He's laughing. Look at all the fish right here feeding. And this might conclude my evening. Yes, it is. One last little crappie. He's lucky. He's a releaser. There's my evening, right there. Catching crappies, having fun. You can do it. Think about it. Ontario in October. We got to split. And let's go.
Think about those big black crappies in October in Ontario or wherever you fish, because they want to bite. You just got to be there. You're going to use the right baits, right presentation. Stay on them. Keep fishing. But remember, fish extreme, fish crappie.